We have something for you. I've got two things for you. If you need really fast inference and you don't care about the UI, if you're trying to build a really quick hackathon app, right? And you don't care about the UI, I cannot recommend Streamlit enough. I am a huge fan of what they do, and they can interact with the Workers AI runtime. If you don't know what Workers AI is, we host models for you, so you don't need to worry about where to deploy them. So if you're going to build an AI app that you want to have a UI real quick with, I know that sometimes people start building really fast, they try to build, and then they never really fully get things going there. So I'm going to show you how to use this template. So I've got two things for you. We've got the Python one. I'm going to show you a Streamlit app. And then I also have a Workers AI one that we can run if you wanted to needed to host it. Like if there was a requirement in the hack that you needed to host it, I'll show you both sides of that. One's in TypeScript and one's in Python. Let's do it. I know you don't have time. You don't have much time. So let's do this. So what you would do is you'd come here and there's this use this template button, because this is one of those template repos, because you don't want to fork it and you don't want to like have to merge things back in. If you do find something that's wrong, please merge stuff back in. But otherwise, take this, rip it, it's yours. So we're going to say use this template. I'm going to click that. I'm going to create a new repository. And my new repository is, I'm just going to say like example for me. Example hacky, whatever the thing is you're doing, hacky demo, example hacky demo. That's what we're going to do. What this is going to do is it made a new repository. This is mine. You can see that it's where it's generated from, but I've got this hacky demo. So I've got this new code that I can copy, and I'm going to bring that down. I'm going to make a new. We'll get in here. We'll get into like a little scratch directory. It's kind of where you know, when you're hacking, you get into your little scratch directory, and I'm going to do a git clone of that repository. I'm going to get in there, and I am going to get a hold of that. Get in there, and this is called example hacky demo. I'm going to open it up in Visual Studio. So here we go. This is what I'm going to do. I am going to come into the Python directory. So I'm going to go into cd python, and in this directory what I want to do is I want to follow the readme, right? I want to open up this readme that's here. First thing that I want to do is I want to do this a vimv. So I'm going to do a vimv where vimv is virtual environment. And then I'm going to activate that, because what that does is it gives me a nice little shell script that I can do here. Now I'm activated. Your terminal might look a little bit different than mine does, but that's okay. Everybody's a little bit different. All right, so I'm going to install all of these requirements. As it goes, and this will install Streamlit, and it's also going to install this Cloudflare package. And now I need to get access to these secrets. I need to get access to make some new secrets. And so what I am going to do here is I am going to go to dash.cloudflare.com. I'm going to get into my account here. I have multiple accounts, not to brag. And then I come in here under AI. Over here on the left, right, we got this workers page. So I'm going to go AI, workers AI. And in here, there's this REST API. I'm going to copy my account ID. And I am going to go into, I'm going to go in back over here to this file. I went out of order. I shouldn't have. I messed up. I'm going to copy that TOML, Streamlit. There's a directory there called .streamlit. It's a little hidden directory. And I'm going to copy those files over. So now I have this Streamlit's TOML, and I need to put my account ID in here. And that was what I just copied and pasted from the dash. So this copy that. I'm going to pop back over. Here we go into there. And I'm going to grab an API token. In fact, I'm going to generate a new API token so we can see how to do that together. So I'm going to say get an API token. And I've got this workers AI for read, all sorts of different things that you can build here. This is nice because it's like the path of least. We want to give the least amount of access possible. Here is my API token. And don't you worry, I will delete this afterwards. So I'm going to paste that in here. I'm okay with sharing that because I'm going to get rid of that. But I never want to get that out because that's associated with my account, right? I don't want to let that out. So that is all set. So if I go back and I look at that readme, I think I've got everything that I need. I do. Now I'm ready to just see what this looks like. So let's run this app. Boom, here we go. Streamlit app is up and running. And it's going to open up in a new window, which is great. And here we go. And we have this little thing here that says, what is up? And I'm going to say, I am going to participate in a generative AI hackathon. I want to use text generation. Give me three ideas that might win, right? So I'm just going to give it a little prompt there. Here we go. It's going to hit that. Now what it's doing is it's doing streaming back. So sending a lot of tokens over. I think I'm using Llama 3. We'll take a look at the code here in a second, but you'll see that it's really nice setup that it's here already for you. This UI is already here for you. You can make it do whatever you want. Like you could change the patterns of however you want things to go. Personalized story generation. I've seen that win a hackathon before. AI generated poetic translations. Pretty interesting. Take some old French poems and turn them into English and also make it rhyme, I think you might win. I think it's a really good one. Thank you. Thank you, Llama 3. All right, so hey, let's check out what that code looks like really quick, and then I will show you the other side of the thing so that you can see how you might be able to tweak this. All right, so here we go. So you come in here and there's this workers. I'm using Streamlit. If you haven't before, it's incredible. It's so fast. I actually copied this from one of their tutorials, right? So you could do this as well, but you don't need to if you want to use this right exactly how this is working right here. So we have this Cloudflare API token. That's what's in my Streamlit's file there. There's this thing called session state. So anytime you see this ST, there's this thing called session state, which basically allows you to store objects and save it as it goes, because the app, you saw the app was kind of going. So I could keep on adding chats and things like that as it went. We have a couple of roles. There's one of user, assistant, and you can also do a system message if you wanted to. This one is not using a system message, it's kind of just raw as it's going. This is really nice. This is that chat input that we did there. And let's see, we're going to append that prompt. So that's why the message went up. We put it in, the message went up. And then you'll remember that it added the new assistant message. And it's really nice, these little context, I think they're called context in Python. What are those called? Contextual somethings. You tell me in the comments. And then onwards here, we have this dot run because we want it to stream. We want those tokens to go one by one as it comes through. And by default, when we do streaming, it returns an event source object. And that's very handy if you are using a web application and you want to just get this event source. It will send these things down. It looks like this. Like each one of these comes down as like the response. And we can take a look at that here later. And then let's see, I wrote a little iterator here. So we're going to iterate over these things that come back, and I'm going to pull them apart and just put the word out as it goes, because that's what I want to do here. So by yielding what's coming from this response here, we're yielding that out, we're writing that to the stream. And that's how it was doing that stream look thing that it was doing, which is very nice because you want things to look fast. And so streaming is always a great way to go. And that's kind of one of those things that sometimes you run into a hackathons where you can't quite get through it. So I'm going to do that. And luckily enough, when it's done, it returns this thing called completion. And then I add it to the thing. 55 lines of code. You can play in here. You can build whatever you want with that. So if you don't have a UI or you don't have UI on your team, I highly recommend doing this with Streamlit. I am going to actually stop the video here, and I'm going to give you, this is the Python version of the video that we should all be happy with. I'll go ahead and I'll do the other one. If you need to deploy your app and you want to do that in TypeScript, I'll do that in the other one. I know I said something different in the beginning. I was lying. There's going to be two videos. All right. Thanks. Good luck today.